Hello, Gilles.
Hello.
I know you don't like puns, but I can't resist and would love to talk to you about the body without organs.
Where is the pun?
Well, as a puppet, you are a kind of body without organs, aren't you?
You mean because I'm hollow? Because there's nothing under this shell of foam?
Oh, well, that's not true, of course.
Never mind. We can still talk about this concept.
Could you please explain it again? Hardly anyone gets what is meant by it. Even Guattari seems to have understood this concept rather different than you did.
Actually, it's not that difficult, but I don't want to start again with Antoine Artaud and Lewis Carroll. Here's a different take. Do you know the distinction between figure and ground?
You mean what the Gestalt psychologists say? That is, that in every perception we make, it is important to distinguish the foreground from the background? For example, words in a book, those are figures, but the paper is the background, and if you mix them up, you can't read anymore.
Exactly. You can also apply this to the understanding of the body, the human body, but almost all bodies of living creatures. On the one hand, there are then the organs, for example, nose, eyes, ears, or heart and lungs, they are in the foreground. They are the figures. On the other hand, there is a background that holds them together, like the letters on a sheet of paper.
You mean the body as a whole or something like its environment?
You know, I actually didn't get the idea from Artaud, but from Gilbert Simondon. He made a whole philosophy out of this relationship between figure and ground. In a passage that is actually about machines, he says, an individual is not only made up of a collection of organs. And then he explains, with regard to the human body, within a living organism, all living matter cooperates in life. It is not only the most apparent or the clearest structures that have the initiative of life in the body. Blood, lymph nodes, and conjunctive tissues partake in life.
So the body without organs is not hollow or empty at all, but a kind of vital environment for the organs, a kind of interior milieu, as Claude Bernard put it.
It is a kind of liquid matrix, a plasma, like inside of an egg or some kind of primordial slime, in which organs take form. But you don't have to go back to the life sciences of the 19th century to understand. You can simply think of the experience of flow.
Then we do come back to art, Artaud, etc. In your book about the painter Francis Bacon, you speak of such experiences when seeing passes into hearing and hearing into tasting and smelling. There, the organs dissolve in a certain way, become soft, begin to flow.
Yes, but that is possible only if the sensation of a particular domain, here, the visual sensation, is in direct contact with a vital power that exceeds every domain and traverses them all. this power is rhythm, which is more profound than vision, hearing, etc.
Sounds like a theory of synesthesia.
You could say that. The body without organs is, so to speak, the soft matrix, the liquid ground, the smooth space that makes synesthetic experiences possible. Hearing colors, tasting music, and so on. Only that this matrix is not just a space, but also a kind of time, a certain rhythm, a time-space, if you will.
I thought you didn't like puns.
I'm a hollow puppet. I'm punning all the time.
You are a theoretical pundit. Thanks.